마음 나열 발리사 오바시 카스미엘 오라부치카 센터 포 사테라 테크놀로지 디벨롭먼트 FCT 아부자 나열.
Good evening, everybody. This evening, I'll be speaking briefly on the space education program in Nigeria, past, present, and the future. This is the outline I'm going to follow. In 1998, the Africa Regional Center for Space Science and Technology Education was actually established by the United Nations. And the purpose of the establishment was for capacity building for space science technology within these English-speaking countries in Africa. Then shortly after the Nigeria Space Agency was created in 1999, the center was actually handed over to the Space Agency as one of the activity center. The purpose of the mandate of the center is to promote space activity in the country. Right from the time this center actually started an operation, a lot of outreach activities as we invite to space activity has actually increased, and the mandate of the center, we believe that we actually target most of our outreach to secondary school students and the primary school students, because we believe to catch them young is a basic thing. And having been inspired by the center in my own very university, we did a lot of outreach to one of another of our space agency center located in my institution. And me into optics because my background is physics and astronomy. We did a lot of outreach, one space outreach. We challenged it to use astronomy as a basis to increase space awareness in my school. We go to schools, we teach students how to design optical telescope and inspire them. And we also started developing our own rocket, but we started with a water rocket. And as time goes on, we go to this very stage and we're able to develop our solid propellant. And when we finish with this very one, then we launched it, the rocket actually got disappeared. We couldn't actually find it because we launched it in the forest because of the security in the school. Then these are some of the things we'll be doing. Regards to most of the, we do a lot of modeling and we use this kind of paper model to control them. And this is one of the things I actually did back then in my school as a project work. This is a 2.4 meter radio telescope. We were able to design the telescope and got a good signal from the sun and Jupiter. I've been designing an optical telescope, and this is one of the optical telescopes we have been designing. With this optical telescope, you could actually see the craters and the valleys in the moon, and also about two moons of Jupiter with it. This is some of the outreach programs we have been doing, and we have been inspired by the center within the school in our own institution. And these are some of the outreach programs we have been doing within the school. And this one, the model, is called an ATIS model. The big ball represents the sun, and the small, the blue ball represents the earth, and the white ball represents the moon. When the white ball comes in between, and that's a solar eclipse, and when the blue ball comes in between, that is a lunar eclipse. And shortly when our original coordinator for UNICEF came back to Nigeria, we invited him to our school, and he taught us about the cancer issue. And ever since then, we have been trying to develop our own cancer. Although now we are still in the process of doing that, and these are some of the programs. Okay, outside, what are we doing in the center? The center, in addition to space education in primary and secondary school, we are trying to focus on the universities today. About 11 institutions are actually signed in to their program. The center is organizing seminars first to the faculty members of each of these special institutions to educate them on space-related issues. Why faculty members? Because we believe that experience has shown the most of the programs that are targeted to students, that when you actually teach these students and you are not here to actually call them to continue, there's always a very big problem. And that is why we target on the faculty members. So even when the state agency is not there, the faculty member could actually continue with the program. And what are these are future plans. We plan with a plan with Nigerian coordination and other people who actually are interested in space activity. We want to use UNICEF Nigeria to promote space education in Nigeria, because I believe that there is a big discrepancy between the Nigerian Space Agency and the institution. And to that effect, we have drafted up a roadmap for ourselves. First one, to get involved in a massive outreach to various universities across the nation, encourage Nigerian Research Institution to be developing space system. Like CANSAT, we have started, and the water rockets we have done, and other rockets we are doing through participation in UNICEF program. Organize space, organize inter-regional competition within our nation and also nationwide competition among other universities. And engage multinational companies to support student activities. We strive to create medium for knowledge transfer for practical space science projects from different parts of the world to that young Nigerian student. We will partner with other organizations that promote space science education, like Space United Advisory Council, Astronomy Without Borders. We plan to collaborate with UNICEF Global. For us to overcome some of these challenges we might face in establishing practical space culture in Nigeria, we want to collaborate with UNICEF Global. We also collaborate with other participating nations to tap from their experience and resources. So every one of you here, we want to collaborate with you. Through collaboration, we hope to achieve our mandate before 2025, following this very roadmap we have set. The first one, by 2014, we want to actually move out for a massive outreach to various universities. When we have done that, by March 2015, we want to organize about 2 weeks of summer school. Within this summer school, we teach the students about CANSAT and other space science projects and empower them. They go back to their various institutions and start developing something. By November of that 2015, we want to organize our first space week. This space week will give them the opportunity to display all what they have learned, they have developed within this period. Through this, we'll be able to build capacity. By 2016 to 2017, we hope that these students should be able to launch some of these projects, the CANSAT and the CubeSat, they should be able to develop within their institutions. In 2018, we hope to also establish a satellite and rocket laboratory in some of our universities. By 2019, we hope that the students should be able to develop their own launch vehicle, multi-stage water rockets. Then 2020 to 2025, we believe that the students should be able to launch this CANSAT within their own institution without the help of the space agency in our country. These are some of the challenges you might encounter, the rigidities and all that motivation. Then in conclusion, we have been able, within the short time, to tell you some of the different activities in space sciences we have been doing in Nigeria, and we hope to collaborate with every one of us here to achieve that mandate. In acknowledgement, I wish to use this opportunity to thank the Japanese government for sponsoring me here, then my regional coordinator for his efforts, and Mrs. Ray Kawashima for her efforts. I only that one I trust you because each time she sent me email, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much.